Hey guys, a very good day to you all. In this video, we will be doing the assembly of the ball bearing which you can see on the screen. Okay, so we'll be doing a bearing similar to this. So let us close this and let us open a new part. The first thing that we will be doing is the inner ring of the bearing. So for that, I'm going to click on front plane, press Ctrl 8 and then click on sketch. Now once this is done, you have to draw one center line of infinite length. Okay, escape, select this line and click on infinite length. Make sure that this line will always coincide with the origin. So select the origin and the line and add a relation coincident. After this thing is done, then select one more center line and draw an infinite horizontal length line. These are basically acting like an axis and will surely help us. Select both of them. First select this line and make it infinite length. Then make sure that this is always coinciding with the origin. So select both the line and the origin and click on coincident. Once this is done, then click on OK. Now guys, after this thing is done, now select the midpoint line and draw one horizontal line. Click on escape. After this, click on smart dimension, select this line and give the dimensions to it as 7 mm. Select this line and its distance from the origin should be 12.5. So enter 12.5. Now after this thing is done, now draw two vertical lines. Okay, draw the second vertical line. Now select this line and draw one horizontal line. Click on escape and click on smart dimension and make sure that the dimension of this is 1.75. Now once this is done, now you have to draw a circle. So click on center circle and make sure that your center of the circle should always coincide with this vertical line. Click on escape. Give the dimensions to this as 4. The diameter of the circle is 4 mm. And the center of this particular circle is at a distance of 15.43 from the center. Okay, now we have to select trim entities and just trim this part away. Okay, now your sketch is ready and as you can see it is black in color, which means that it is completely defined. You can now end your sketch. After this, you have to select your sketch, go to feature and go to revolve boss base. In the revolve boss base, it is first asking for the axis of revolution. You have to select this axis of revolution. And after this thing is done, then click on OK. Okay. So your inner ring is now ready. So you have to save this file now. So press Ctrl S. And guys, I am going to save this file by the name inner ring and I will click on save. Done. Now this file is saved and now I will close this particular part. Now it is time for us to create the outer ring. So click on new, click on part and click on OK. The same procedure for here as well. Click on front plane, go to sketch and click on sketch. After this, you have to draw one vertical line and a horizontal line of infinite length. Okay. Click on escape, select this line, then click on infinite length and click on OK. Make sure that this line will always coincide with the origin. So selecting both of them, click on coincident and click on OK. You have to now draw a horizontal line. Escape. So select this particular line, make it infinite length, click on OK. select this line, select the origin, and make sure that the relation of coincident is being added. Okay. Now after this thing is done, again you have to draw one horizontal line using the midpoint line. Click on escape. Give the dimensions to it as 7 mm. And after this, make sure that you draw two vertical lines. Click on escape. Draw one horizontal line from here itself, and then one vertical line. Click on escape. Now go to smart dimension. Give the dimensions to it as 1.9. After this, the dimension of this particular horizontal line from the origin, it has to be 37 divided by 2. Hit enter. After you are done with this, now your next job is to draw a circle on this particular vertical line. Click on escape, go to smart dimension and give the dimension to it as 4. After this, select this particular center and its distance from the origin has to be 15.43. Click on smart entities, trim this away and trim this. Now guys, as you can see that you can see some blue color sketch over here. So for that you need to define more. So I'm going to click on smart dimension, define this with respect to the vertical line. And now as you can see, your sketch has become completely black, which means it is now fully defined. Now after this thing is done, you can now end your sketch. Okay. Now guys, select this sketch, go to features and click on revolved boss base. Again, it will ask for axis of revolution. So you have to select this particular axis. Once this is done, then you can now click on done. Now you have to save this by the name of an outer ring. So press Ctrl S and save as the outer ring. I'll click on save. So we are done with the inner ring and we are also done with the outer ring. Now the next job for us is to do the cage. So I'll end this particular part. Click on file, click on new and click on part. Now I'll again click on front plane, go to sketch and click on sketch. After this, the first thing that you have to do is to draw a circle. Choose center circle. Give the dimensions to it as 30.86 mm. Okay, click on escape. Select this circle and make it for construction. After this, select this particular circle and click on offset entities, because I want two circles inside and outside of this dotted circle. So I'll click on bidirectional and now I will click on 0.5 and enter the data as 0.5. okay, now after this I'll now click on OK. Now you can end your sketch. Select this sketch, go to features and click on extrude boss base. Keep the distance as 10, it is fine, and now you can click on OK. After you are done with this, select this particular face, press Ctrl 8 and click on sketch. You have to draw a center line. Escape, make it infinite length. Click on OK. Select this, select the origin and add a relation coincident. Draw a circle exactly on the vertical line. Okay, escape. Now guys, the distance of the center of the circle from the origin, it has to be 15.43. Now after this, give the dimensions to this circle as 4. Now what you have to do is that you have to draw one solid line starting from this point till here. Click on escape. Now I have to select trim entities and just trim the half part. Okay. Now I will click on OK. It will be better if you know the design of the case so that you will also understand what is going on. Now guys, you have to now click on features. First select this cage and then click on revolved cut. And can you see a cut will be provided at this particular sphere. Now you can click on OK. Now after this thing is done, you have to now add a fillet. So let us click on fillet and the items to fillet, select this edge, add it as 0.3 mm. Okay, similarly here enter 0.3 mm. Okay, and now you can click on done. Okay, after this thing is done, this is just for one ball. You want for 18 balls, so you have to click on circular pattern, select the features and faces. I'm going to select this particular feature. See, cut revolve appeared over here, and I'm also going to select this feature. And here I have to enter as 18, and in the direction I have to select the direction of a circle in which I want the pattern. So as you can see, I'm getting a cage ready for 18 balls. After this thing is done, now the next job is to make use of the shell feature. Now in the shell feature, you have to select this particular face, select this face and select this face. Now once you are done with this, enter the shell amount as 0.3 and then click on OK. Okay, so as you can see, now your cage is ready. Now you have to make holes for the rivet. So for that, click on front plane and press Ctrl A. After this, select this particular face and click on sketch. Now guys, select the circle command. Click on escape and give the smart dimensions to it as 30.86. Okay. Now after this thing is done, click on escape, select this circle and make it for construction. Okay. Now we have to select one vertical line and draw up to this particular point. Click on escape. Similarly, you have to draw one more center line up to this particular dotted circle and give the smart dimensions to it as 10 degrees. Enter. Now on this particular point, what you have to do is you have to draw one circle and give the dimensions to it as 7. My bad, 0.7. Okay. Now after this, just end your sketch. Now select this sketch, go to features and click on extruded cut. In the extruded cut, what you have to do is you have to select through all both, then click on OK. Now the same thing you want over here, 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 like this, you want the same thing 18 times. So I'll select this cut extrude feature and I'll click on circular pattern. In the direction, so I'll select this particular edge and as you can see, I am getting a hole on all the points wherever it is required. Okay. Now once this is done, now you can click on OK. So now we have to save this file. So press Ctrl S and save it as cage. Okay. Now after this thing is done, now just close your part. Now it is time for us to create the ball. So click on new, click on part and click on OK. After this, click on front plane, click on sketch and draw a simple circle. Use the smart dimensions to it as 4. Now select one solid line and draw it from this particular point, dividing the circle into two halves. Now click on trim entities and trim away the half part. Now you can click on OK and just end your sketch. Select this sketch, go to features and click on revolve boss space. Okay, in the axis of revolution, select this particular straight line and your ball is now ready. Press Ctrl S and save it by the name of ball. Click on save. Now after this thing is done, now you have to create the rivets as well. So I'll close this. I'll go to file, click on new, click on part and click on OK. So again I'll click on front plane and click on sketch. Now after this, first thing I'm going to draw is the circle. Okay, give the dimensions to this circle as 0.7. Enter. Now after this, what you have to do is draw one horizontal line which will divide this circle into two halves. Click on escape. Select trim entities and trim the bottom part. After this, select one solid line. From here, draw one horizontal line. Click on escape. Give the smart dimensions to it as 0.15. Okay. Now once you are done with this, now you have to draw one vertical line. And again one horizontal line. Click on escape. Give the dimensions to this vertical line as 1. And the dimensions to this as 0.15. Okay. Now once you are done with this, now you have to draw one center line. Click on escape, select this line and make it infinite length. Okay. Now once you are done with this, now you have to select the center point arc. The center should be on this vertical line. Go up to this point and then again bring back to the vertical line. Click on escape, click on smart dimensions and give the dimensions of this center to the origin as 1 mm. Now click on OK and after this thing is done, now click on trim entities and trim this part away. Now take one solid line and join the ends. Okay. Click on escape. Okay. Now select this sketch, go to features and click on revolve boss space. The revolve boss space, it is asking for axis of revolution. Select this particular axis and your rivet is now ready. Then press Ctrl S and save this by the name of rivet. Now you can close this particular part. So guys, now since all our parts are ready, now it is time for us to do the assembly of these parts. So for that, I'll click on new. Click on assembly and click on OK. Now you have to import all of them, the cage, the rivet, the ball, the outer ring and the inner ring. Click on open. So first is our ball, then we have the cage, then we have the inner ring over here, the outer ring and here is the rivet. Now what you have to do is that, click on mid. Select this particular plane and click on front plane and apply the mid. Similarly, you have to apply the mids for this particular face and the front plane as well. Now the next thing that you have to do is to select this particular edge, select this and see a concentric mat is being applied. Okay, after this thing is done, now you have to click on OK. The next thing that you have to do is to select this inner ring, right click on it and click on fix. Similarly, you have to right click on the outer ring and you have to click on fix. Now guys, right click on this ball and make it float. Now what you have to do is that click on mate, select this ball, select this particular face. Now click on anti-align and then click on OK. Now as you can see that your ball can revolve in this. Can you see? It can revolve in this. Okay. Now guys, after this thing is done, now what you have to do is that since you want 18 balls, therefore you will go to circular component pattern. In this you have to select a direction. The direction that I will select is obviously this thing, and in the components to pattern is this particular component. And how many do I want? I want 18. Okay, now click on OK. Now the interesting thing is that if you move one ball, then all will move with respect to that particular ball. Can you see? Okay, now after this thing is done guys, now what you have to do next is insert one plane. So I have to go to file, I have to go to insert, click on reference geometry and click on plane. After this, in the first reference I'm going to select this particular face, in the second reference I'm going to select this face. So a plane will exactly be inserted in between these two plates. Now I'll click on OK. Now what I have to do next is that I have to now select apply mate. Select this face and select the plane that we have created now. Okay, click on OK. Now once this is done, you want the axis of this particular circle and this case to be the same. So for that you have to introduce two axes now. So what you can do is that in the reference geometry you can click on axis and in this click on cylindrical or conical face and select this particular face. So can you see one axis is now being created? Okay, now click on OK. After this thing is done, click on mate, select the axis. So as you can see, I have selected the axis and select this particular plane of the cage. Can you see? Now you can click on OK. Now you can find out guys that your cage, first click on OK, that your cage will move only with respect to this particular axis. Okay, and since we have applied the mate on the face, therefore it is not going to come out of this bearing as well. But the problem here is that guys, if you observe carefully, then see, this cage is not exactly over the ball. It has to be like this, right? It has to be exactly over the ball, but it is not. So for that you have to apply one more mate where you have to select the face of the sphere and you have to select this particular edge. Okay, and see, now you can click on OK. Now if you revolve this one thing, then the whole thing, that is the cage and the ball, everything is going to get revolved. Even if you revolve the ball, then you will see that the cage will also revolve along with that. Can you see? Now it is time for us to create one more cage on this side as well. So for that I'm going to click on mirror components. In this, the mirror plane, I'm going to select this particular plane to be a mirror plane, and the components to mirror is this particular cage. I'll click on OK, and can you see, now one more cage is being created. okay. Now the next thing that we have to do is to obviously insert the rivet. So for that, click on mate, okay, select this particular face of the rivet and select this face, okay, click on OK. Now after this, select this edge of the rivet and select the edge of the hole where you want to place the rivet. You can select any edge, okay. So can you see now the rivet has appeared here. Click on OK. See, okay, you can observe the rivet from this side as well. Click on OK. Now you want 18 such rivets, right? So I'll obviously click on circular component. The components to pattern is this particular rivet. And how many do I want? I want 18. And in which direction? You can select any circular direction. See, can you see? Now you are getting 18 such rivets. Click on OK. So guys, now your bearing is completely ready. Can you see? Everything is moving with respect to the other. Now guys, one problem is that I forgot to apply the fillet at this particular edge and this edge. So what can I do now? So for that, I have to again open the inner ring. So go to file, click on open, open the inner ring, select this particular, select fillet, select this face, select this edge and select this edge as well. Here enter as 0.3. okay, now you can click on OK. So can you see a fillet is now being applied. Press Ctrl S, close this and you will observe the changes. Click on yes. Similarly, I want a fillet at this particular edge as well. So for that, what I can do is next, I'll open the outer ring, file, open the outer ring and in this I'm going to select fillet, select this particular thing and enter as 0.3. After this thing is done, select this edge as well and click on OK. Now press Ctrl S, close this, click on yes and you can observe the changes in the assembly as well. Okay. Now guys, once you are done with this, now it is time for us to give it a realistic look. So what you can do guys is that since the sphere is, the balls are repeating over here, so you can open the ball part. Click on open and here you can directly give it the look. What is the advantage of this? See, if you give it a look directly over here, suppose if I give it brass, click on polish brass and click on OK. So since I have given it a look over here, press Ctrl S, close this and you can observe the changes in all the balls present over here. Because what we have done the circular pattern of the ball. Okay, we had only single ball and we have done the circular pattern of it. The same applies to the rivets as well. Okay, so you have to open the rivets. Click on open. Click on edit appearance. And here, go to steel and click on polish steel. Click on OK. Press Ctrl S and close this. You can observe the changes in the assembly. Now, the next thing that you have to do is to simply select this, you know, cage that you have drawn and you can even select the inner ring and the outer ring. Go to edit appearance, in this go to steel and click on polish steel, click on OK. Okay, so once you're done with this, now you can observe that this particular cage is not done. You can select this cage too. You can go to edit appearance, In this, go to still, click on polish still, and then simply click on OK. Done. So your ball bearing is now, guys, ready, and you can observe it is done perfectly because it is all the parts. See, when you try to rotate one of them, all the parts are actually revolving the same like the ball bearing. So I hope, guys, that you have understood this simple assembly. Guys, thank you for watching this video.